One of the RVCA's primary responsibilities under the Conservation Authorities Act is to protect people and property from natural hazards like floods and erosion. We do this with the help of hazard mapping, which uses detailed modeling to predict where those hazards are likely to exist. Hazard mapping uses information about a region's terrain and waterways to predict where and to what extent a hazard could occur. So, how do we do it? First, we have to decide where mapping is required. Working with our municipal partners, we determine where flood hazard maps need to be updated or created, especially in areas that are up for development. It's important to have hazards identified before development begins to avoid building in the hazard areas and preventing increasing risks elsewhere in the watershed. We regulate to the 100-year floodline. Despite the name, this doesn't mean a major flood is guaranteed once every 100 years. It means there's a 1 in 100, or a 1% statistical chance that a major flood will happen in any given year. That's why we saw 100-year floods on the Ottawa River in both 2017 and 2019. If the conditions are right, it can happen in any year. After we've chosen where to map, we need to model the flows. This can be done two ways. In large systems like the Rideau River, we have gauges that regularly measure water levels and flows. With a long enough record, we can use that data to statistically determine what the 100-year peak annual flow will be. But if the record is too short for accurate results, detailed hydrologic modeling is required to assess summer rain and spring snowmelt events. To do this, we need to have a good understanding of the landscape in terms of terrain and elevation, land use and development, and catchment drainage. Next, we take those flows and apply them to our hydraulic models to calculate water levels at hundreds of locations across the project area. The first step is to carefully and thoughtfully place cross sections along the waterway so they accurately capture the landscape and critical features. Structures like this small pedestrian bridge need special attention and must be accurately represented in the model. Our hydraulic models rely heavily on terrain data, and it is absolutely critical for predicting water levels and flows in flooding events. The final technical step is mapping our results to see how far the flood will go. Our GIS team stitches together the water levels from the hydraulic model, creating a continuous water surface across the landscape to determine the extent of the flood and to come up with our regulation line. We then review our findings internally, send them out for peer review through our municipal partners, and then we bring the draft hazard mapping studies to the public for consultation. We'd love to answer any questions you have about the flood mapping process. Thanks for tuning in.